SSR or simple sequence repeats. These are tandem or continuous repeats of 1 to 6 bases found in genomes of eukaryotes. SSR are also known as STR, short tandem repeats, microsatellites, SSLP. Based on repeat motif length, SSR may be mono, di, tri, tetra, penta or hexa repeat. For example, AT is a di repeat if it is found continuously in a single stretch for at least 6 times. For molecular studies, monorepeats are not well suited because of stuttering or smearing effect and poor resolution on gels. However, di repeats are more suited because they show more variation than rest of the other repeats. Based on their occurrence in the genome, SSR may be genomic or genic. Genomic SSR may belong to coding, non-coding or intergenic region, but genic SSR are always found in coding regions. Genomic SSRs show more variability than genic SSR. While in terms of their amplification or transferability to related species, genic SSR are more cross-transferable. Now the question arises, why SSRs show variation? One of the main reasons for SSR variation is replication slippage. Because when DNA polymerase tries to replicate the repetitive DNA, it gets confused and it may lead to addition or deletion of one or more repeats. In this case, DNA polymerase finds it difficult to read 80 repeats and may increase or decrease SSR length in individual 2 and 3 respectively. Other reasons for the variation in SSR length are mutations and recombination during meiosis. Now we know that SSRs are prone to replication slippage. Individuals of a population have chances to show enormous SSR variation. Using SSR flanking primers, variation in SSR length is determined in different individuals. In this example, SSR marker is designed for 80 repeats. When this primer is used to amplify DNA of different individuals using PCR, similarities and differences between them is determined based on their length on agarose gel. In this agarose gel, individual 3 and 4 are having same length fragments, hence they are similar at DNA level than individual 1 and 2 who are different based on 5 base pair DNA ladder reference on the right. Advantages of SSRs as marker. SSRs are codominant, that is, they can distinguish between homozygous and heterozygous individuals. They are hypervariable, that is, they show high degree of polymorphism. SSRs are stable and the results are not influenced by the environment or developmental stage. Even 50 nanogram of DNA is sufficient for the study. SSR markers are sequence specific, that is, they amplify a specific DNA region. SSR markers can be automated using Sanger sequencing to study polymorphism. SSR assay is fast. Multiple markers can be checked in a single reaction and thus they are well suited for multiplexing. Their occurrence in the genome is random. SSR markers produce reproducible and reliable results. Now we know that SSRs have many advantages, that is why they are having so many applications. They are well suited for the variation, diversity, phylogeny and population biology studies. Contamination or purity of plant material or variety can be easily evaluated using SSR markers. Similar to SNP markers, SSRs are well suited for linkage mapping, QTL mapping, genome-wide association studies to determine marker trait associations. SSRs are successfully utilized for marker-assisted selection of allied genotypes or screen the trait of interest. Male or female plants can be distinguished using sex-linked markers. SSRs are successfully used to fingerprint humans for checking parentage and criminal identification. Now some of you may be interested in developing or designing your own SSR marker, so this slide is for those people. For this you will need DNA sequences either downloaded from the public databases like NCBI, Ensemble, etc. or you can generate your own sequences. Next, you search these sequences for SSRs using tools like MISA or SSRIT. Once you know the sequence, you design the SSR flanking primer using Primer 3 or Oligo Calci software. Now you have the SSR primer and you can validate it by amplifying it in the genomic DNA and check the results on the agarose gel. In this gel, SSR marker is validated in 13 individuals. You can see the differences in the banding pattern. Such polymorphic markers are used for various applications that we have already discussed.